Last Sunday, I want to thank you viewers all over the world. I encourage you to fast and pray on Thursday that I'm seeing a very, very serious tragedy happening in the nations. I want to tell you today that actually, you know, I told you in the past that anytime I'm given a message, I have to reserve my comment, because the way Amana people begin to take my message and they don't understand things of the spirit. But the Lord chained me, my leg and my hand, to talk last Sunday. If not, I would not actually talk. I decided not to talk, but I was forced by the Spirit of God to talk. But this is as far as I could go. I was showing the nation, the name of the country, the whole thing will happen. But I decided to reserve my comment. But I personally, on my own, I was on my knee praying for the nation, but I decided not to mention that country in the public. But I was on my knee. I've been for the past 2 weeks praying for the country, the name of the country. I was even thinking of, if the Lord permit me to fly over the country for the prayer, because what I saw, what happened is an atom. What I saw that could have happened that Thursday, if not prayer, would have been going to at least 1,500 people. The bomb inside the vehicle would have exploded and killed 1,000 people and everybody. But God just want them to see sign. It's just a sign. But we should thank God. And I want to thank you for your prayer. Viewers all over the world, thank you for your prayer. I will continue to talk. I will continue to talk because of the viewers and those who are under the influence of this program. I will continue to talk. I may not speak out all, but I may summarize my word and reserve the rest to myself, like I did on Sunday. Instead of mentioning the name of country, I said, please, I'm seeing a country. Please, what is going to happen is a unique something that nobody have ever heard. This is a tragedy attack, and I say Thursday to happen. If you know where I was on Thursday, even my evangelist, well, when it was around 3-2, they came to me when it was around 3 p.m. or 2. My evangelist came to me that, sir, something happened in Kenya, they killed 5 police. I said, that is not the one I saw. That one is not the one I saw. The one I saw in the vision, when it happened, it will shake the whole world. You say, ah. They came to me at 2 p.m. that Thursday when I was right in the room. They said, sir, something happened in Kenya. 5 police were attacked by militant. They did. I said, no. No, you are ignorant of things of the spirit. What I'm seeing, what I saw happen today, it was around 2 p.m. I said, what I saw is not these 5 police. I just want the prayer of viewers and all over the world, when the prayer answer, it will reduce the tragedy. And I now call my boy. I say, look, this thing will happen, but it will not be serious because of the prayer. It's unchangeable. The only thing that can change it, if they are not gathered. And they must gather because they are doing anniversary. And nothing can stop that gathering, because I learned it was independent. Nothing could have stopped it, because it's a traditional issue. They must gather to celebrate, to celebrate and do light fire. But I told my evangelist, I said, look, at 2 p.m., he said, this is what happened in Kenya. I said, no, it's not Kenya. The one I say is not Kenya. This is the place, my brother. He say, this is the place. But it will be very, 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 very serious. But because of prayer, it will subside and reduce to an atom. He say, I say, he was asking me that with prayer to stop everything. I say, is it possible to stop everything when the day of gathering? Can you tell the nation not to gather? Very important occasion. It's not possible. It must happen. It's unchangeable event. That is 2 p.m. He went by. That is my evangelist. So this is why we gather here. I have a message for you today, which I'm going to share with you, maybe as we move forward. Okay. And So I have just a message. I mean, for you. So, but charity begins at home. Let me take care of you first before talking to the whole world. If I'm telling the whole world what is going to happen, and you are sitting in front of me and I cannot tell you what is going to happen to you, what kind of pastor is that? If I'm right, I say, if I stand here telling you what is going to happen to a nation, and you are sitting in front of me and I could not tell you what will happen to you, if you believe me, it means something is wrong with you. Yes, standing here and they telling you that something will happen in this country, something will happen in this country, and you are sitting down, I can't tell you what will happen to you next. What kind of prophecy is that? In every area of life, as it is written even in the Bible, charity begins at home, education begins at home, knowledge begins at home, even things of the spirit begin at home. Are you with me? In the Bible, everything we do start from home. How to greet, start from home. Education, you say you are a professor today, that you start from home. Nobody here start learning 1A from school. You learn it from home. No one, how are you, sir? These are the things we learn from home before we go to school. Even in literacy, they learn little education at home before go to school. Things of the spirit, writing, your father will tell you, say, good morning. He will tell you that, no, don't talk anyhow, respect elder. These are the character we learn from home. It's not church, you learn all this. The knowledge start from home. So if I now start here and begin to tell you, this is what is going to happen to that country, this is what is going to happen to that country, and here you sitting before me, I can't tell you what is going to happen to you. Well, if you believe me, it means something is wrong. So once again, I thank you for supporting, for your prayer. Because if not your prayer, is what you are saying. When the tragedy, the attacks happened, I immediately got up. I look, I said, oh, thank God, thank God, thank God. When they were talking of 84, I said, oh, thank God, thank God. Because what I saw is not 100, it's thousands. But God stopped this. God will have stopped all. If it is possible for you people not to gather that day, because they have to gather for anniversary, and it's a traditional thing, they cannot avoid it. Even if you meet the president of that country and say, so, president, this is what is going to happen, if Jesus met the president of that country that day and say, this will happen, he cannot stop the gathering, because it's a tradition thing. People go out, even without the government ask them to go out, they have to go out and do what they normally do every year. So it's unchangeable event. So, but I want to thank you for your prayer and for what God is using you to stop. Thank you very much. And right now you have to begin to believe yourself that God loves you. God can hear you. If you believe that, let us see your hand. With what God is using you to do. Huh? You know God loves you. You know, I told you how to get the heart of God now. Take care of your heart first. When it is time to talk, to meditate, take care of your heart. You have to look inward. Not Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Jesus, 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 Jesus. No. Before you talk of Holy Ghost, talk of Jesus, just talk of God. Whatever you talk of, please, your heart. Because that heart is the contact point. If there is no place to contact it, definitely you can't get God. You can't get Holy Spirit. And your heart must be free. When your heart is free, it's sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Then he can contact Holy Spirit. Amen. Married Holy Spirit, John Holy Spirit, when it's free, when your heart is free.